Hello world, it's Samanyu and you are watching Vijaya. In this video, you're gonna learn how to make a website in just 10 minutes. By the end of this video, you will be able to make many different kinds of websites using just drag and drop. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first thing that we're gonna do is click the link in the description of this video, which will take you to this page. All right, now we are gonna scroll down to step number one. So the first step is to choose a name for your website. Now we're going to head over to this box and type in the name that we want for our website and then click on check. If it says that the name is available, then we are good to go and we can proceed to step number two. So the second step is to get a hosting and domain name for your website. The domain name is your website's address on the internet. For example, the domain name of Google is google.com. And hosting is basically a computer where you can store your website's files to make it available to other users on the internet. Alright, now let's scroll down to step number two and then click on this Get Hosting and Domain button. This will take you to siteground.com, which is where we are going to get our hosting and domain. As you can see, there are three plans that we can choose from. So if you just want to launch one website, then you can go with the startup plan. And if you want to launch multiple websites, then you can choose the Grow Big or the Go Geek plans. To keep it simple for this video, I'm just going to go with the startup plan. So I'm going to go and click on the Get Plan button. So now it will ask us to enter the domain name. So we are just going to enter the domain name that we chose in step number one and then click on proceed. Now just fill in these details. Right, now in the purchase information section, the data center that is closest to you will automatically be chosen, but you can also choose any other option. So I'm going to go with USA because most of my website visitors are from the USA. Then it will ask us to choose the period, which is basically how many months we want to sign up for. It will give us the option of 12 months, 24 months, and 36 months. The longer the period that you choose, the more discount you will get. So for this particular video, I'm going to just leave it at 12 months. Next, we can ignore the extra services section and then confirm the terms and conditions and then click pay now to finalize our hosting and domain. So our account has successfully been created. We can now proceed to the customer area by clicking on the proceed to customer area button. All right, now the step number three is to set up your website by installing WordPress. WordPress is a website platform that will allow us to quickly create our website without knowing any programming language. So on this setup screen, click on start a new website, then choose WordPress. Now you need to fill in the WordPress login details. So fill in the admin email, the username and your password, and then click on confirm. We don't really need these enhancements, so click on confirm once again and then click on complete setup. All right, so now WordPress has successfully been installed and our website is live on the internet. Now if we head over to our domain name, we can see that our website is live and anyone anywhere in the world can access it. As you can see, our website is pretty blank right now as there is no content. So let's head over to the WordPress dashboard and customize it as per our requirements. So just add slash login in front of your domain name and hit enter. This will take you to the WordPress login screen. So just enter the username and the password that you created earlier and click on login. Now scroll down and click on exit. So this is the WordPress dashboard, which is the area where we can customize our website. Now head over to the plugins tab and click on installed plugins. Then deactivate the WordPress starter plugin. And then we are going to delete it. So just click delete and click OK. Now let's head back to the dashboard by clicking on the dashboard button. In order to view your website, you can just click on my blog and then click on visit website. So this will take you to the live version of your website. So the step number four is to customize your website. To make our website look cool, we are going to install a theme. So to install our theme, we again need to go back to the dashboard. So head over to my blog and then click on dashboard. Now head over to the appearance tab and then click on themes. Then click on add new. And now in the search box, we are going to search for the theme called Astra and hit enter. So this is the theme. We are just going to go and click on install. Then click on activate to activate the theme. All right, now let's click on get started to start the sign up process. So this will activate all the plugins necessary for this theme. Now we are going to select Elementor as our page builder. So click on Elementor and click on next. Now we can select from more than 100 ready-made designs that we can directly import into our website as a starting point. So you can see all these different kinds of designs that we have available here. So I'm just going to choose the first one called Accountant and then click on Preview. So this is basically how the website will look like. You can just scroll down and see the whole website before importing it. So after you're satisfied with a particular template, just click on Import Site. This will take a couple of minutes and import the demo website into our own website. Once it's done importing, we can click on View Site to view our website. So as you can see, the demo has been imported into our website and now our website looks pretty cool. We also have multiple other pages, so let's go to the About page. So this is the About Me page. We can see this one as well. We can also go to the Contact page. So this is where the users can contact us. We also have a map here, as you can see. Now let's just head back to the main page. Now step number 5 is to add content to our website. So let's say we want to edit the homepage. So we are going to go and click on Edit with Elementor in the top bar. This is going to take us to the Elementor panel. So now let's say you want to change the text here. So we are just going to select it and type in our new text. Similarly, we can change the text here. Let's say I want to replace it with Welcome to my website. So I'm just going to type in that. And that changes it. Now let's say I want to update this button. So just click on the button and type in the text section. So I'll type in Contact Me. Similarly, I can click on the image and then select an image from my computer. And then click on Insert Media. So this will update the picture there. Isn't this very simple and easy to do? Similarly, you can change anything on this web page. So let's say I want to change this to List of My Services. All right, now when you're done, you can just click on the Update button in the left panel. That will update the page. And then to view the site, just click there and then click on View Page. So as you can see, the website has been updated with your own content now. Now let's say you want to update the logo and the header and the footer of your website. So to do that, you're going to click on the Customize button in the top bar instead of Edit with Elementor. So that will take you to this screen. Now in order to update a thing, you can just click on the blue icon next to the thing that you want to update. For example, you can change the logo by updating the images here. You can also update the logo width here. You can also update the site title, which is basically the title of your website as it appears on Google. Similarly, you can update the tagline, which is basically the description of your website as it appears on Google. So as you can see, the title has been updated here. Now let's say we want to update the header menu here. So we are going to go back, again back, and then we are going to click on menus. Then we are again going to click on the menu button there. And this is basically the header. So we can just rearrange any of the items in the menu by dragging and dropping it. So as you can see, that has been updated. Similarly, if we want to delete an item, we just click on it and click remove. So that will remove it from there in real time. Similarly, we can also update the footer menu by going to the footer menu option. So after you're done updating, you can click on publish. And that will basically update the website as per your updates. Now let's say we want to add a new page to our website. So we are going to go on the new button there and then click on page. So this will take us here. So now we are just going to type in the title of our web page and click on edit with Elementor. There are two ways to add content to our page. We could either drag and drop widgets. So let's drag and drop the heading widget. So we are just going to put in the title there. And then similarly, we can drag and drop other widgets, like let's say the image widget. So I'm just going to choose an image there. Let's say this one and then click on insert media. So this is one way to do it. The other way is to use the pre-built templates. As you can see, there are lots of pre-made templates available here that we can import in one click. So we are just going to select one and then click on insert to insert it into our page. So I'm going to click on insert here. So again, we can modify our template as we did earlier. So we just select what we want to update and then replace it with our own text. Similarly, we can do this with every other thing in the template. And when we are satisfied, we can just click on the update button and then click on the view page button to view the updated site. Well done, you just built and launched your very own website. So that was it for this video. I hope you liked it. This video should be everything that you need to get started with building your website. I will also be making an in-depth version of this video very soon, so don't forget to subscribe. And thank you very much for watching. Till then, stay connected.